Comrade, this video and me talking like a Spetsnaz warrior is clearly inspired by the original video by Pavel Tsatsouline, Enter the Kettlebell. If you want to watch his original video, do it. It will teach you a lot, like it taught me when I was a beginner. However, if you're short on time and you're looking for condensed information, stay here and observe. My name is of no importance to you. Just know this. I was taught by Steve Cotter from the IKFF, who was once working with Pavel closely. I was taught by Sensei Steve Cotter in the art of the Gurboy kettlebell training, or as I like to call it, the kettlebell sport style. Interesting, isn't it? An American is teaching the Russian style of kettlebell training, while a Russian is teaching an American version of it. And by watching this video, you're learning it from a guy who is neither American nor Russian. Life is funny. While my demeanor is certainly an act, the lessons I'm about to teach you can be taken serious. Comrade, it is of critical importance for you to understand this one thing when it comes to safety measures, or you will instantly be MIA. The kettlebell always wins. Take a look at your kettlebell and observe. It is made of steel. It is powerful. It sure as hell doesn't care about your feelings. It doesn't have a nervous system. Therefore, it knows no pain. You, on the other hand, comrade, no matter how tough you are, you have bones that can be broken and blood vessels that can be ripped open. If the situation occurs that the kettlebell wants to go its own way, leave it be. Do not try to fight it. And sure as hell, get out from under it. Comrade, you can seriously hurt yourself if you don't choose to properly warm up before each kettlebell session. You might think you're saving time, when in reality, you're just stupid. Never even think about touching a kettlebell before mobilizing and stretching your muscles and joints first. If you are a beginner, make sure to choose the right weight. Men and women alike can start with an 8 kilo kettlebell. Anything below 8 kilo is not a real kettlebell and therefore will not provide you with the right benefits of real kettlebell training. Choose your weight and choose your fate, and remember the color codes. For those comrades who live in the basement, in a prison cell, or in a small shack in the Siberian tundra, this advice does not apply. The rest of you might want to choose some good rubber flooring at home, because we want to remember the first rule. The kettlebell always wins. If it does, make sure it is able to drop to the floor without destroying it. If you choose to ignore this advice, your fate will be decided in an argument with your wife. Comrade, when advancing to the final stages of Gurboy training, you will learn how to snatch. Brace yourselves for all the hand skin you will lose if you advance in weight and if you increase in your rep ranges. It will hurt and it will rip open your hands and calluses will form. However, these attributes are of no importance because you will get stronger. Comrade, as a beginner, you will properly learn how to deadlift. Stand shoulder width apart over your kettlebell and make sure it is resting on the middle of your foot. Initiate the movement with the hinge. Your upper body leans forward. Stretch out your arms down into your knees. Grab the kettlebell. Lift. Breathe out. Breathe out. This is how you do a kettlebell deadlift. Comrade, you have probably heard of the kettlebell hand-to-hand swing. The deadlift is its foundation. Make sure to learn it correctly with proper form. Do not advance to the kettlebell swing if you have never even heard of the kettlebell deadlift. Watch and observe to learn the kettlebell press. You stand shoulder width apart over the kettlebell. You grab it with one of your hands. Doesn't matter if it is left or right, we will do both hands, comrade. Initiate the movement. Hinge. Upper body is leaning forward. Grab the kettlebell. Clean. Drop the elbow into your hips for the so-called rest position. Comrade, you're now ready to engage in the movement. Press the kettlebell overhead. Drop it down. Breathe. Comrade, we have a line that we want to follow. It is called the medial line. As you can see, I am pressing the kettlebell upwards, following this medial line. One of the most important foundations in the kettlebell Gurvoy training is the rest position. As you can see, my elbow is resting on my hip. Make sure to learn this movement correctly. Comrade, we're not disco pumpers. Therefore, we want to train the legs just as hard as the upper body. The kettlebell squat is performed accordingly. Initiate the movement to grab the kettlebell with the hinge. Upper body is leaning forward. Grab the kettlebell. Pick it up and switch grip. We now want to squeeze the kettlebell, engaging the pectoralis muscle. Comrade, you have to observe. Don't be stupid and engage in a back squat when in reality, we are now engaging in a front squat. We now want to the following cue. Chest up, toes pointing out, and knees following the toes. As you can see, my back stays straight. As I have mentioned, do not engage in a back squat. If you engage in this manner, you will probably feel the exercise more in your back than in your legs. And this definitely is the wrong way to engage in a kettlebell goblet squat. Comrade, we're now engaging in one of the most foundational exercises for real kettlebell training. The kettlebell hand-to-hand swing is a very powerful movement. It engages your posterior chain, your glutes, and your hamstrings, and your core. Don't be stupid and stand shoulder width apart over your kettlebell because you will waste your first rep. Instead, take one step back. Engage the movement with the hinge. Upper body leaning forward. Grab the kettlebell. Comrade, one of the most important cues you want to remember is the following. Maximize the time your arm is connected to the body. Minimize the time your arm is disconnected from the body. Comrade, as you can see, I'm engaging this movement from my hips, my glutes, and my hamstrings. My core is here to stabilize. My arms don't do anything. If you start pulling the kettlebell too fiercely with your arms, you will not engage the right muscles. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and go watch the original video from Pavel Tsatsouline called Enter the Kettlebell.